The Asian Development Bank expects the Indian economy to remain strong over the next 2 years, with GDP growth projected at 7% in 2024 to 2025 and 7.2% in 2025 to 2026. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's comments about tensions on the border with China and his hope for a restoration of peace and normalcy in relations between the two countries have been met with reactions from both India and China. The Indian Air Force assures there will be sufficient funds for them despite the consolidation of capital allocation for all military services in the 2024 to 2025 defence budget. The Supreme Court of India overturned its own decision in a high-stakes arbitration case, highlighting the tension between finality in legal judgments and ensuring justice. Lindy Cameron, a UK cybersecurity expert with experience in Afghanistan and trade, is the first woman-appointed British High Commissioner to India, taking the role at a key time for India-UK relations. The Asian Development Bank urges India to simplify trade policies and better integrate into global manufacturing networks to achieve its ambitious growth goals. The Asian Development Bank warns that India could be the most impacted economy in Asia if the US Federal Reserve maintains high interest rates for a longer period. Apple, Incorporated now refers to state-backed attackers as mercenary hackers and customer email alerts and has updated its website support documentation accordingly. Sonam Wangchuk, a Ramon Magsaysay Award winner and climate activist, addressed a crowd in Leh, Ladakh, urging global attention to regional climate change challenges. ISRO's PSLV-C58/XPO-SAT mission has left minimal debris in orbit, transforming the last rocket stage into an experimental module and ensuring safe re-entry. CAR T-cell therapy modifies a patient's T-cells to combat cancer. Dr. Purwar returned to India in 2013 and found CAR T research lacking.